hello everyone and welcome to FPL Clue for another video. Today we will be doing a Gameweek 21 team selection video. Please leave a like and subscribe the channel for more weekly FPL content. Massively appreciated. This is how my team performed so far, with Crystal Palace versus Manchester United and Manchester City versus Spurs still remaining. I have Luke Shaw, Cancelo if he starts by the way, KDB, Rashford, Martial who is still a doubt as well, and of course my captain Erling Haaland still to play another game. But so far it's 47 points and red arrows all over. Kepa got a massive 10 points alongside Marcus Rashford who has another game in hand. Trippier and KDB are the other two players who got some points returned for me. Hats off to Rashford captainers or triple captainers, they are in a winning situation at the moment. But let's not forget that Erling Haaland is still capable of outscoring Marcus Rashford. Going into Gameweek 21, I still have two transfers and 1.7 million in the bank, and there are some changes that I'm thinking I will do before the deadline. It's ideal to go in Gameweek 22 deadline with a 2 free transfer because there might be some double Gameweek to be confirmed, but I actually am planning to use both my free transfers this Gameweek because those red arrows are really impacting my overall ranks. So let's see how my team will shape up for Gameweek 21. We will talk about the transfer as we go on. In goal, I will again start Kepa. I know he has a difficult fixture against Liverpool, but Ward on the other hand has a game against Brighton who are as attacking or even more attacking than Liverpool. Especially if Nunez is not fit for Gameweek 21, then I think Liverpool will cause less problems to Chelsea defense, and Kepa is capable of making a lot of saves as well. As things stand, I'll stick with Kepa in goal. Moving on to the defense, Luke Shaw has a difficult game away at Arsenal. The way Arsenal are playing at the moment in defense and attack, there is very less chance for him to get a clean sheet or attacking return out of this game. But the way Manchester United play at the moment, they can surprise you in every aspect of the game. So I will stick with Luke Shaw as my first defender going into this game week. Cancelo has started the game against Manchester United, but his minutes are still not guaranteed. Will he start against Spurs in tomorrow's game? I don't know. Will he be back in the starting 11? I don't know either. But the plan is to keep him for another week because I need to focus on some other areas of the field for this game week. He plays against Wolves. If he starts the game, then there is a chance they keep a clean sheet. Will he get bonus points as well? Probably yes. So the plan is to keep him for another week and see what happens. Next is Trippier. He continues to do his type of stuff. Clean sheet, bonus points and some happy days for all the managers who own him. Newcastle is the best defense in the league. They kept 5 clean sheets in a row and there is a high chance they continue to do so against Crystal Palace, West Ham and Bournemouth all the way until Gameweek 23. And Trippier might not only get clean sheet points but also the bonus points as well. He is still owned by 68% managers, so for those 32% managers, it's still not too late to bring him into your team, and I promise you won't regret this decision. And Dank completes my 4-man defense for this game week. He is having a very slightly easier game away at Leicester, who are not doing very good in attack, especially in James Maddison's absence. They have only managed to score 1 goal after the restart, so there is a high chance Brighton will come away with a clean sheet from this game. Moving into midfield, KDB is the first midfielder in my team. I'm glad I brought him for Salah last week. Even though he had only 1 assist against United and 5 points in total, he still has a game against Spurs. And not only that, he has another confirmed double game week in game week 23. KDB has not been at his very best after the restart, but with player of his caliber, you can expect a goal or multiple assists any game against any opponent. If we think about Haaland's blank, is it because KDB is not providing him assists? Quite possible. So let's really hope that he rediscovers his form and kind of prove us that the form is temporary and class is permanent. Next is Martinelli. I don't need to tell much about him. He is a player that offers a great value into your team. Only concern is with Smith Rowe back in action, what will be his impact on Martinelli's minute. But other than that, as I said in my previous team selection videos, Martinelli is a must-have FPL asset and you cannot build your team without having him in your squad. Next is Almiron. The Newcastle attacker haven't started his best after the restart. He has now blanked in 3 consecutive games. But the fixture swing for Newcastle means that we might again occasionally see him on the score sheet or assist sheet. But then there is another issue with him. With Isak back from injury, I don't know how will it impact Almiron. Will Isak be the starter and Almiron often gets benched? Or maybe there is no impact at all. It remains to be seen, but these are the concerns, and with him blanking 3 consecutive games, I have decided to move him on. The ideal replacement is Martin Odegaard, I believe. It's not a very good game week to bring him in as they face Manchester United, but I believe the form he is in right now, I think it's best to acquire his services as soon as you can. Manchester United are looking a good team, but they still need to improve more defensively, and Arsenal might cause them a lot of problem in attack. And I won't be surprised if Odegaard have a couple assists or even score a goal against them. They have confirmed double gaming in Gameweek 23, so I know that I need a third Arsenal player in my team anyways. I believe there is no harm to go for the former Real Madrid player a week earlier, and it might pay me off well enough. Next is Rashford. He will not have the best fixture of his life against Arsenal away, but he is in great form, and I won't be surprised if he tears the Arsenal defense apart and score a couple goals against them. Long story short, you can't ignore a player of his standard and form from your starting 11. He actually is a captaincy candidate for most people, so he will be in my starting 11 no matter what. Moving into the forward spot, Erling Haaland is my first striker, and there is no doubt about that. Just like KDB, he is a player with class. Form is temporary and you can expect him scoring a hat-trick against any opponent. I know he has blanked and there is no player in the history of football who keep on scoring in every single game, but he has the hunger and we will see him back in the score sheet probably tomorrow against Spurs. Next is Nunez. I'm not sure about his injury or extent of his injury. Will he play in game week 21? I don't know. So that's why I've decided to move him on and sell him, and Toney looks like a good replacement. He is in form, he is consistent, he will face 3 easy opponents in the next 4 games. It still remains to be seen what happens to his legal matters, but until then, I will rate him as one of the best FPL assets. The fact that he is so consistent and has easy opponents and he is on penalties and great form really makes him an interesting pick. Bench players include Ward as my backup keeper, injured Martial. Let's see if he makes squad in today's game against Crystal Palace. If he doesn't, then I might move him onto my third bench. White and Andreas are the other bench players. Haaland is gonna be my captain for this game week and KDB is my vice captain. And that's it for today. I hope that you guys enjoyed the content. Please leave a like and subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you guys in the next video.